People in cities across the country today in the March for Medicare for All. On this National Day of Action, they demanded Congress expand and improve Medicare.
WGN's Jenna Barnes is in the loop where the local march kicked off a little earlier today.
Lourdes and Taman, these advocates are marching because they say health care is a human right. More than 100 people marched from Maggie Daley Park to Federal Plaza to draw attention to their fight for Medicare for All.
Congressman John Lewis said, if you see something that is not right, not fair, and not just, you have a moral obligation to do something about it.
That's why they rallied along with people in more than 50 other cities across the country for a single-payer health care system.
Are we so star-spangled awesome that we can't figure this out and everybody else can?
Advocates for Medicare for All are calling for zero copays, zero deductibles, full dental and vision coverage, and no out-of-network restrictions.
If you get injured outside of your predetermined health care network, you have to pay for it all. Where's the freedom in that?
A Gallup poll earlier this year found 1 in 5 Americans can't afford the care they need. A Pew Research study last year found 63% of U.S. adults say the government has the responsibility to provide health care coverage for everyone, something proponents say we've seen glimpses of during the pandemic.
You show them your ID, you get your vaccine, you're done. That's the universal health care they always say can't work here, but it did work here.
Critics of Medicare for All say the federal government can't afford it. It would require a tax hike to pay for, and it would eliminate private insurance.
So I think we could be number one. We used to be number one at everything in America. I don't see why we can't be number one in health care outcomes, too.
The organizers of this effort say they'll file a human rights violation with the UN if the U.S. government doesn't take action on Medicare for All by August 6th. Reporting downtown, Jenna Barnes, WGN News.